So you think that just because somebody doesn't have a disability doesn't mean that they don't have trouble remembering things? Well, unfortunately, I'm afraid you're gonna have to try to understand something, and you're gonna have to listen carefully. As you can see in this pie chart, you might notice that in the spring green area, 80%, that's how much rememberability you have to be able to have, and no less, in order to realize that you have a repetitiveness problem, and that's what you gotta do. I mean, you can manage it on more, but if there's less than this, that person is gonna have a repetitiveness problem. You gotta think about it. Some people have that problem because of things, if you see what I mean. And so it won't do any good to get impatient, because that doesn't change the genetics in someone. That's not right. Now, if we think we have a right to respond to people who repeat stuff the way we do and never care what's wrong with them, well, it makes that other person look guilty and left out just because they can't remember well enough for others. It creates arguments and then resentment between people, and soon there's no friendly communication anymore. People lose comfortability with others, and there's nobody nice to help them out. You might end up losing out on the good stuff with nearly everybody in the world. It encourages a person to talk about revenge with the other person, or maybe even damage to that other person. Fights get out of hand and then lead to situations with the law, with the police and the court system end up having to use whatever they have to stop the situation, and money is lost to damage and fines because of a person having to fight back time and time again. And that's all in the hall of shame right here with this person silhouette of black and white stripes. Now, if we took the time to realize that that person's ability to remember is recessed below 80% because of genetics and requires neurophysiology to fix, well, it helps that other person feel like they have a need to belong in society and be trusted by other people. People don't have to argue and resent each other, and friendly communication carries onward. People keep their comfortability with others for as long as they want to and become more willing to help them. You end up being offered to more good stuff with more people in the world. It gives a person better ideas than talking about revenge or damage to other people. Fights are easily prevented and saved from the law, with the police and court system having to use whatever they have to stop the situation. We don't have to worry about losing money to damage and fines over a person having to fight back anymore either, and we all get medals for that. But here's something you need to understand. Your negative responses just because you're tired of hearing things are no good. They're spoiling for everyone. They're ruining it for people. And then it's making it very hard for them to think of nice things anymore. And the way you always say stuff like, well, you sure do need some memories erased, every time they say that happens to them, every time you respond negatively, that talk is gonna stop right here, right now. That is not okay. If it's reported you've been saying that, there will be an automated intervening machine installed there saying, excuse me? Don't you pseudo-listen to what he's saying? You turn around and you listen to him, what he says, heed his situation right now, and apologize for that response. That's what it's gonna do, and it will do that with every impatient answer you say to him, and that's just the way it's gonna be. There will be no one being unkind anymore, and you're not gonna offer anyone any punishments just because you're tired of hearing the same thing. That's that. You do not offer them, you do not tell them how to prevent anything. And if you really want to say you're through hearing something, you can do it just so in a polite way. You can just simply politely ask that the subject not be spoken about again. It may be uncomfortable, it may be pretty bad, but it's perfectly, but that's the right way to respond all the time. And one more thing, you do not ask if somebody is F-U-S-S-I-N-G. That word is a bad word to some people. A lot of people have allergic reactions to that. All you gotta do is ask politely, and then see if that person is. Maybe tell people how you feel about the subject, and then you can pick and choose later. And if you're nice, you get just what you want. Good day.